These two are looking to pocket a lot of points. Best of seven, world number one Fan Zhendong to start it off. Quality backhand inside the table for the first point, Wang Chuqin. Now some differences. Fan Zhendong is very explosive, generates a lot of spin and power. Wang Chuqin, a lot of power with more of a forward motion, aggressive near the table. Just seems like every shot he takes, he's going for broke, as opposed to the more consistent spin that Fan Zhendong uses in his aggressive shots.
For sure, it's a difference we've seen in Xiaopan. He actually goes back and lobs more than we've ever seen him. He's added a bit of feeling, variation to his game.
Almost blocks that one back cross court, but the heat. Wang Chuqin, boiling point here on this forehand.
It's quite a straight arm on the forehand, isn't it, compared to a lot of other players you see within the Chinese national team.
Which is really quite a compliment, because the Chinese national team hits with the straightest arms of anybody in the game. And within that small selected group, Wang Chuqin, the straightest of them all. That means a lot of racket speed coming into that shot. Takes a lot of strength from the waist, the legs, and the shoulder.
Yeah, I mean, it's almost three. Heavy, heavy backspin, like it's nothing. Powers through. Learns from his losses. And rock solid clutch for Team China in Chengdu earlier on in the month when it came down to the deciding match against Team Japan. Mentally, you really can't fault him, won't you, Chin?
Six.
But it feels not long ago. It was 3 years ago in 2019 at the Hungarian Open.
Six.
He's on the scoreboard now, Fan Zhendong.
I just feel like anyone that's beaten Wang Chuqin outside of Team China, it's going to be a win that ages very, very well. I mean, Cassan's beaten him before as well, Alexandre Cassan from France, but couldn't really see him getting near him nowadays.
The punch on the backhand, redirecting traffic. As fast as that ball comes in, no hesitation, and fully prepared, the lion-hearted Wang Chuqin. One, two, and the third time's a charm. Done, baby, done.
Backhand down the line when he was a bit out of position. So, so good. One of the best in the world at that, if not the best, Wang Chuqin.
And finally a shot that doesn't come back, way in the back court. Wang Chuqin getting a few rockets, just turned around on course. Look at that fanning shot from under the table, scoops and everything else.
Racket finishing so high on that forehand. It's quite an unusual style, but when you're out of position, play with spin. Slow it down to give yourself time to come back in where possible.
The more secure shot indeed, but Fan Zhendong on the scoreboard two times now. Interesting here, haven't seen this in a while. The way he just closes and accelerates out in front, that snappy backhand. Even for Fan Zhendong, we're not going to see a shot quite like that too often. I think that's just the pace that Wang Chuqin brings in these rallies. Goes for broke, leaves the front door open on the forehand side of the house. But security set. Well, now.
All cards on the table. Ace forehand.
Yeah, that's just as hot as they come. And in the touch game as well.
Backhand flick, although Fan Zhendong has an unbelievable Chiquita and backhand flick.
Doesn't miss by a lot. If you've been watching this entire event, there is no question. You know that Wang Chuqin will never give up, that he can chase down just about anything. That extra side spin on it, making it bend even further out of reach. The step around on the backhand corner, and it is now six game points for the underdog by world ranking, by head-to-head, by almost every standard. Wang Chuqin looking to make a statement here in the first and get some serious momentum for pressure against his opponent, the world number one. Beautiful backhand there. A little acknowledgement for some fortune. Seemed like maybe the top edge of the racket here from Fan Zhendong. That Wang Chuqin fan's always in the front row with that digital sign right over the rails.
Seems like his fans also love Sha Sha as well.
It's the next generation, I think.
Yeah. To you.
And that is all 11-5. Wang Chuqin taking game number one. Be a cool name. Wonder if that's taken.
Let's check it out.
Back here, game two to start. It's a good chase, a good effort here from Fan Zhendong. Out of position, we don't see too often. Wang Chuqin doing a good job to get his opponent out of position, but never easy. The quality of shot needed for a point. A little surprising to see Fan Zhendong come in for a long push on the receive. Maybe that's what he's going for here. When you're playing a teammate, I think the element of surprise is much less normally.
Mm. Beautiful serve, but well read there.
One.
See the bottle challenge serve predominantly coming from left-handed players with backspin and side spin down the line, usually into the backhand side of a right-hander. Fan Zhendong doing it, the complete reverse there.
Well, they do have a mirror, righties and lefties.
Yeah.
He stays so close to the table. Wang Chuqin is able to be aggressive from pretty much anywhere on the court. Trying to recall the last time I saw Wang Chuqin lob.
Very, very rare. I can't remember either, actually.
It seems like it might be against sort of his core values.
Yeah.
Let. Two. Two.
That's why it makes for such good matches when Wang Chuqin plays Trulles Morrigard, who he's beaten two times in a row now.
An in-between shot on the table, just long enough. Wang Chuqin, I think shots that are half long for others feel clearly long to him. Watch him handle this slightly loose ball. Well, a little bit more. It's just a handcuffing serve is what that is. Perfect serve to set it up.
Ooh.
Three.
This is that one, but yeah.
They've both learned a lot from Ma Long over the years. The reason I bring that up is
arguably
one of the greatest matches in modern history, the 2017 Men's Singles World Championships final with Fan Zhendong and Ma Long. Statistically, Ma Long did not take the attack first as often as Fan Zhendong did.
Mm.
Yet he still won points that way and won the match. So he was the less attacking of the two players. He didn't get the first attack.
Yeah, Ma Long flicks less than a lot of Chinese players do as well.
He's very comfortable to leave a ball in an uncomfortable place for you and say, I'll just block it back aggressively. Speaking of aggression, letting off some steam out here, a quick turn. You use the word careful, and I know what you mean and agree. I think intentional play out here. Fan Zhendong can't get caught in between. Tied up now, 4 points apiece. Serves with Wang Chuqin.
Wow. Beautiful forehand fade there.
Four.
From Wang Chuqin.
That long step as he turns the corner. So tough to see where he's going to go, but just guides it out the other way. Full extension once again.
Five,
I mean,
five.
In the women's game, we've seen Ding Ning, left-handed world champion. But in the men's game, haven't seen a left-handed world champion since Gatian from France. Can Wang Chuqin break the pattern?
Although, I guess we'll have to see at the next World Championships, which will be coming up in Durban, South Africa next year. But here, this champion's a whole lot on the line. Net recovery for Wang Chuqin. Wow. To jump and still keep that ball in play, the danger of his wide forehand. Fan Zhendong trying to play it as wide as can be.
It's like a Dark Knight back on that one. He does the jump.
Right down the line as well.
Seven,
as fast as can be, a little off the net.
Seven, six.
Perfect start here. And Fang Zhendong, right out of that second towel break, especially on the receive. A little bit of side spin there. The Chiquita down the line, jamming up the backhand side of Wang Chujin. The Fang Zhendong fan club enjoying this. That's interesting for me because the first shot there was a tough one, but we don't see Wang Chuqin slowly spin it often. It just felt like the whole tone of the rally was a bit unusual.
Yeah, for sure. And the serve, he stalled a little bit, Fang Zhendong. He's not doing the reverse pendulum so much at the moment.
Seven, nine.
Events here. 5 points in a row for Fang Zhendong. Even with the parallel opening, two in a row there, Wang Chuqin. I think that combination seemed good enough, but not against world number one. Now three game points for the world number one. Fang Zhendong takes his chances. Ooh, a dribbler, a little fortune off the top of the net to save a game point.
Oh. Let's not forget that semi-final against Truls Morgaard could have gone a very different direction. Wang Chuqin had to save game points many, many times. Didn't tell the whole story, the scoreline.
And he saves three game points in a row. Wang Chuqin under pressure. We saw him down 4-9 in probably one of the most nerve-wracking and devastating situations for Team China in a long time. So we know that he can handle pressure. But playing against world number one right now, he's evened it out. So alternating serves, deuce in game number two. Ripping backhand, low spinning shot comes in. How does he pull off a shot of this quality?
That is unreal. Look at this. Tight touch, half long. Oh, you can't hit it better. Into the middle, too. Double trouble for the world number one.
And now game point to Wang Chuqin from down 7-10, four in a row. Perfect. Half long, gets a little bit of a double pump there. A little hesitation from Wang Chuqin. Looks like he thinks he's going to have to play it passively, and by the time he makes his attack, he's already that much less time. Just 11, a little bit more behind. 11. But if he decides too early, I mean, it could bounce a second time on the table and he might not touch it. So, second deuce point here. Back down the line, the cross court backhand was not enough. It did not deter the power of Fang Zhendong.
So, so good.
Game point now for the world number one, the defending world champion. Right down the line, as sneaky as can be. Third deuce point. So yet again, another game point here for Fang Zhendong. Doesn't seem like a bad way to start the point. That deep push by Wang Chuqin. And that's all he needs. just 14-12. So a quick look at the racket. It is Fang Zhendong. And here we go, game three to start.
Love
good length
one.
There on the push.
And they're both serving into each other's forehands because of the imminent flicking threat from both sides of the table.
Right back down the line, one, as quick one. As can be.
Wang Chuqin may want to try and touch or push the ball with the forehand instead, because if he flicks from the forehand side, he's then leaving the wide backhand exposed, as Fang Zhendong just illustrated.
I mean, how many times have we seen one, this step two. Around now that just destroys the opponent, yet Fang Zhendong gets the racket up and counters it back to the open short side of the table.
Just too pretty. Too pretty. It's one of the most attractive shots in the game, that.
Calm down.
Sorry. Just can't help myself.
3-1.
He's got a solid record against fellow Chinese players. Fang Zhendong, 67%. Wang Chuqin slightly lower at 38%, but he's still a considerable amount younger.
Yeah, I think slightly is a bit of an understatement. It really goes to show how complete the game of Fang Zhendong has become in the last 5 years. He's had some painful losses, mostly to one man. That man was cleared out of this event by Wang Chuqin. Smart play, a little bit more into the body on this one.
Both of these players' personal coaches are penalties.
Which is interesting, because in terms of generations, the previous generation, the Qin Zhijian generation, Liu Guoliang and others, most of the players were pen holders for China. You can see there's barely any bounce on that black forehand side of the racket, that Chinese rubber.
Four.
One thing I love about these matches where there's so much on the line is that it just keeps getting more intense. The players really push themselves. They leave nothing behind. Push yourself to the limit today. Ice bath if you need. Chill a bit. Take a flight tomorrow.
Got it! 4-5. Stop. Table is wait.
Timeout diffused from behind the table. This is the Wang Chuqin that we've seen almost anywhere on the court. He seems confident to play dangerous shots. That last backhand, so loaded. I mean, a rip of a swing. Shots in a row look like it is for sure going to win the point.
Five, seven.
I mean, it's still medium, just midway through the game. First point since the timeout. Six, Fang Zhendong seven. Back within one. Maybe second. He was down 4-5, I guess. That step around.
Eight.
It's just six. Got so much commitment to it. There's no hesitation. It's not a soft, calculated shot. It's turn and give everything you've got. And he knows where he wants to go. Deep to that corner.
It feels like we want to chin. Intention and execution are almost exactly on the same wavelength. It's that clarity of thought, and
yes.
To have that in the key moments too.
Good setup, smart play. Fang Zhendong slowing it down, not getting quickly into the rally. He knows that Wang Chuqin is very hungry, very ambitious, and very aggressive, so he forces him to play soft first, come back in a little bit later to leave a looser ball to attack.
together.
Eight.
Could be pivotal in this match. I mean, you can't make a much better shot from under the table in that position. Around the net seems incredibly unlikely. And as low as that ball was, even Fan Zhendong was surprised.
Mm. Goes for the step around. Wang Chuqin willing to put it there, because if Fan Zhendong commits and Wang Chuqin can block it to the open space, probably point over.
Cracking backhand, so much momentum as he comes into that ball, moving way forward. Wang Chuqin. Just top of the net, that low trajectory. He makes a high percentage of the time, and a timeout now. Both timeouts called here in the third game. But quickly saved. I mean, this is the real fight. The entire match, it will be a battle. But game number three, the fact that they both use their times out, they are bidding on game number three. The auction continues to go back and forth here. What a change, slow and spinny first, and gives Fan Zhendong the big quality opening to counter back. Makes him pay with that expensive forehand. It's tough to come back from that position, especially against a ball so wide on the next shot. So game point here, Wang Chuqin, serve as well. And Wang Chuqin takes it. Fan Zhendong with the open backhand. Cross court would not have been easy, but it just carries long. A massive game. It's always interesting when you make the first point back after a tough loss for the last point of the last game. Just thought to myself, and you think to yourself, why couldn't it have happened before? But not these players here.
1-1.
So what do you think it's going to take for Fan Zhendong here to stop the power of Wang Chuqin?
I think he has to take the forehand, perhaps the first forehand, into the forehand of Wang Chuqin. If he goes into the middle, Wang Chuqin can cover. And Wang Chuqin has blocked him wide a few times.
Well, here he goes for the middle, and it opens up the wide forehand.
2-2.
Again, if you're newer to table tennis, you haven't seen it played competitively before, you might think, why don't they just hit it to the corners of the table? But they're both so fast that they can easily reach that. They'll play for the middle first, try to get the opponent in the elbow where they hesitate, and then create an opening on the corners.
2-3.
Anytime they can get the opponent to play it just a little bit later. Fan Zhendong in front by one on the receive. It's just too good.
To play the parallels like that, and then the short sides, when you're stretched, it's like, okay, I'm going to give you something uncomfortable.
3.
Reverse
5.
Pendulum, that's like the Zhang Jike Mark II.
Yeah, it's funny. We see it now more with the young generation, I feel like. Fan Zhendong, Liang Jingquan. I have to wonder, though, yeah, Zhang Jike was the first player that I recall being like, it's a really signature serve of his.
Mm.
Oh, speaking of signatures, not even time to sign that one. Xiaopeng, little fatty, that's his nickname, the world number one. Oh, this is a smart time to play it slow and spinny. Fan Zhendong, if that ball comes deep on the table, which is normally the habit, keep the opponent away from the net, but look how low that ball is. Fan Zhendong with a Xuxin-like swooper from under the table. Just blocked by his own side, otherwise it probably would have come down. Still 2 points in front, the world number one, Fan Zhendong.
Let 6-4.
Tight serve, lifted just up and out.
Here you can see the float serve, low to the net. It's low to the net, it's very hard, unless you Chiquita it to drop the backhand into the table, because the surface blocks your ability to do that.
Faster and faster they go.
six, seven.
Good pressure here from Wang Chuqin to bring it back within 1 point. No timeouts left. So no matter how tough the situation is, they're both going to have to rise above. But only one really can. In the end, we will only have one champion. And this soft touch play. He just drills this ball. The timing. It's amazing to me that while the body's busy moving, the arm is already rising up to get the racket above the head for Wang Chuqin. Watch this last forearm. There it is, that forehand, so wide.
Yeah. As soon as the rally enters its open phase, you won't see the players dropping the bat beneath the player surface unless someone throws in a chop or a backspin ball.
Yeah, unless you have time, it's pretty rare. They keep the racket high, you're right. Seven serving eight now. What a recovery here, the net favoring Wang Chuqin in this rally, and still Fang Zhendong able to come in with that banana flick backhand, the side and top spin over the table shot. Oh, he played the push there. It was the banana on the other side.
Managed to keep the net tight on the retouch too.
Crowd loving the replay. Little bit of expression never hurt nobody. Just licking the outside of the lips there, as if to say, man, got to do better next time around.
Eight.
Not the third one. Into the middle, he does it, jams him up. Really attesting and trying game number four, Fang Zhendong. Timing, Fang Zhendong changing up his rhythm here and there to break the patterns.
Left one.
Too strong over the table.
It's unreal, isn't it, how he can produce so much power with his short stroke while the ball's still within its length. It's just crazy. Puts pressure on the server as well, knowing that someone can flick even from the forehand side with the backhand.
Love.
I think that's the most we've heard from Fang Zhendong this entire match, and it was all in the grunt to get down for this ball. He's one of the quieter players on the Chinese national team. Just keeps his emotions to himself a bit more than others.
Yeah, for sure.
Three, love.
And I think Wang Chuqin has quite a lot in terms of what in common with Zhang Jike. We mentioned him a few times, haven't we? The legend, but
there is that fire inside, that deep fighting spirit. You can even see the word fighting on some of the Wang Chuqin posters here in the crowd.
It's possessed by ambition.
Well, now, looked like he was possessed with power on that one. The backhand as wide as can be. Look at the timing on where he takes this backhand. Forehand, and then out in front, just a snap. Not much of a swing at all.
Similar start here in game five to what we saw in game one.
Love five.
Anything could happen. Again, as long as they're keeping score, this is only game five. It's crucial in the sense that it sets someone up with just one more game to win to take the title. Wang Chuqin has never taken a third game without winning the match in their last five encounters.
Whoa.
Recovery here from Fang Zhendong. That serve got away from him.
Yeah, that was such a surprising serve. Bouncy, more bouncy. And Wang Chuqin makes the adjustment. Fang Zhendong there with the high racket and early timing.
Wow. I mean, you might have even thought it caught the edge or something. In the replay, it seemed clean.
Mm.
But it just really came up high for this level of play.
Yeah.
How does this not bother Wang Chuqin? Those first two shots from Fang Zhendong are enough for most players in the world.
Well, they were training with each other before this match, which is something that I usually only see Team China players doing, warming up with each other before big finals. See Ma Long do it also with Fang Zhendong. It's
But in all fairness to that point, 7-1 now, Wang Chuqing leading. Just too strong. Now, in terms of score lines, I'll mention this again. This is game number 5. Sure was. Very calculated shots after those net recoveries. A little bit more time, and Wang Chuqin is focused. I think this is part of the reason that we didn't see the world number 3 at the Olympic Games, because Wang Chuqin is so good under pressure. Quite dependable. Also, he's an investment in the future. I mean, he's the only player of his age group for Team China to be playing at this level. It's devastating how long Fan Zhendong can stay there and withstand those slaying arrows. Just the power that comes in. And still, Wang Chuqin has enough energy to send back one more to finish. Look at the replay.
Speechless. Sometimes actions don't even deserve words.
9 game points here. Only needs the 11-1. The prophecy has been fulfilled. Well, now. Game 6, Wang Chuqin to start it off.
Love one.
And I feel like he has a point to prove at the champions, Wang Chuqin. Let's not forget, Christian Carlsen defeated him at the European Summer Series straight after he'd won the star contender.
It's a good reminder. I did completely forget. Christian Carlsen's been having an incredible year. Wang Chuqin still is getting more and more solid against a variety of styles. But when you're 1-6 against a teammate, it leaves a lot to be desired.
Yeah, for sure.
Tied up here. 2 points. Evenly split.
2-1.
I just had a memory, Adam, back to Halmstad 2018, when Fan Zhendong had to save match points against João Geraldo, Portugal. I think that's the biggest scare in terms of what would have been an upset against Fan Zhendong.
Inside the table, strong with the backhand.
It's never the man in the mirror that's troubled Fan Zhendong. It's just been the opponent, someone more experienced than himself. It took Ma Long a good few times to become world champion. Made his debut in, 2009? Had to wait till 2015 to become champion, and Fan Zhendong made his world championship debut in 2013.
Good pressure here from Fan Zhendong. It is a must-win here for Fan Zhendong. He must win this game. And then the one to follow. Look how low the shots are from that camera angle. You could really appreciate that the ball was so tight to the net. It already feels like a very different game than we saw. Smart play, a little bit wide. Fan Zhendong starts to step around the backhand corner, and Wang Chuqin plays it out to the middle, which stretches Fan Zhendong.
Being able to look peripherally, as well as focusing on the shot, is so, so important. Didn't have to be too much down the line there. Down the middle was enough. Fan Zhendong had exposed himself too prematurely as to what he was planning on doing.
Comes out, Lionheart, the passion. I think you and I have both watched him play from when he was a child.
Yeah.
In his teenage years, he was a lot more vocal, and he settled down quite a bit. But in these big moments, I mean, these are the real, crucial, and critical points. Nice response to the long push.
Yeah, definitely. Fan Zhendong, very good. Gets back into the lead, back in front. Serve with Wang Chuqin. So it's interesting to see if a player chooses to go for the same serve after a let card, or if they'll switch it up.
Yeah, it does seem more common that they do switch it up.
5.
But that is an interesting point. Anytime someone sees two serves in a row, if they're the same, it better be shocking. This is surprising for me. I mean, it's good placement. We've got to hand it to Fang Zhendong for bringing it back so deep after Wang Chuqin was hugging the back of the table.
His attacking game is similar in terms of kind of aggression as to what it was, Fang Zhendong, when he broke through in 2013. But his defensive game, his ability to stay in the point and then construct it, has become so much better.
So this is another time where the slightly spinnier, more arcing ball pays off. Fang Zhendong seemed quite early in committing to the counter. The timing here, you can see how far out in front he had to reach as this ball comes down. Watch one more time.
Yeah, took it a little bit too much in front of himself because once you think, that's like a combination between Wang Chuqin and Wang Chunting, but
yes,
more loopy.
Yeah.
Didn't come through as quick.
And seven, he caught the back seven. Edge of the table. Ooh, Fang Zhendong says, no, it didn't. Okay, I was just reading off of the hand signal.
Yeah, I thought the same there. Barely ever seen two Chinese players argue at the table. I've seen it in tournaments within China.
And this...
Clay.
This was not much of an argument. It was simply he thought it hit. Fang Zhendong said no. Wang Chuqin said, okay, big brother. Mm. I think that was it.
Yeah.
Pretty much the opposite of an argument.
Oh, yeah. Not at all.
Disagreement for a moment, if anything.
Yeah, yeah.
But that's a clutch point. Imagine, I mean, it would be 7-8 right now if nothing else had changed. Let's take another look here. Just in case. So Wang Chuqin's shot from the backside. To me, it looked like it might have.
Oh, that one did.
Yeah, no questions about it here.
Eight.
It's tough to know. Eight. Sound is such a big indicator if trajectory barely changes.
Yeah, that one was played inside the table, so impossible to be a side.
Just funny, from that camera angle, it was also tough to tell. But in real time, yes. Quick as can be off the bounce.
Nine.
1 point closer. Fang Zhendong just 2 points away from sending this to the seventh and deciding game. Flip off the net and out. It is now 2 game points for the world number one. One game point save, Wang Chuqin.
He's incredibly good, isn't he, at slowing things down when he's actually behind. Fang Zhendong might be expecting something a little bit more aggressive because Wang Chuqin is in a more pressured position.
This is mental maturity for me.
Yeah.
Or the 22-year-old Wang Chuqin. That takes a lot of guts and a lot of, well, bravery, foresight. Second game point here. And he takes it. You know what to do. The last game of the entire event is coming right up. So grab those healthy snacks and beverages. With the momentum and the serves to start it off. It is such a thing of beauty in this exchange, how quickly he turns Wang Chuqin to get that full stroke forehand on the step around. Even less than a full stroke on this, just the power that he generated, it felt like it had to have been.
You just know that neither player is going to leave anything spare. They don't want any regrets at the end of this match.
The touch game, it was a hot potato rally. for me, the real true demonstration of why they call him Lionheart. The first grunt, he was out of position. He hesitated for a moment. That one just lost one step.
Oh my goodness. You see how low and deep that was? He almost took it off the floor, Wang Chuqin.
Not a point dropped yet. Second serve here for Wang Chuqin. And it's the spinny one, the arcing shot. I know he loves it. A little bit off the top of the net here. They will switch sides of the table as one player has reached 5 points. Always on the same side of the table. Interesting. That said, he's on the other side now. Only on the odd sides. And is there. That's just incredible.
Filthy, filthy counter topspin. Beautiful. Mopping up that attack there from Wang Chuqin.
I thought he had him as soon as he went parallel. Wang Chuqin gave it back to the backhand, and Fan Zhendong still improvised and recovered.
That's where you really get to see the physicality. That ball there, I mean, that's perfectly into the middle, and yet he still manages to power through a backspin ball.
World number one, 2 points in a row, serves back on his side. Both of his points are on his opponent's serve. This one's so sneaky. Leans forward, just drives it quickly down the line. It's not the first time we've seen him put past Fan Zhendong here without a chance of return.
Against the momentum. It's against the momentum where you cannot physically actually recover. Too much of a movement to ask of a human body.
Let 2-7.
It's an unnatural movement, having to go receive a ball that's against your momentum. And the momentum all with Wang Chuqin right now.
Just misses the edge on this one, looking for that wide angle from the middle. Suddenly, 2-7 feels like it's amazing. Just 1 point difference. 2-7 feels like a runaway. 3-7 feels like tough to come back from, but not in the same category. I mean, we've seen 3-7 comebacks time and time again. Seven serving three now. The underdog, Wang Chuqin, in the lead with the serves. That was the perfect setup. The slow one to the backhand, and it's all relative here. But the spinny one fools Fan Zhendong. He has to backpedal after he starts to turn. Right there. Still keeps the ball in play, which is pretty impressive, but not much he could do after that. Wisdom from the 22-year-old Wang Chuqin.
A little single shoulder shrug there, bit of swag.
And given right back down the middle. Interesting. We've seen Wang Chuqin slow it down a little bit and play relaxed successfully. But in this point here, it didn't favor him. Fan Zhendong within 3 points now.
He's creeping through a closing door. Can you imagine?
It's not going to be easy for either player coming in second place tonight. But the quality of this backhand, he keeps his cool. He knows not to look at the finish line. When you're on the tightrope, it's the last three steps where most people fall. When they think they're already there, they lose the focus. And the shake of that tightrope, 9-5. Unbelievable that he can run that down and keep that pressure on. The heart of the lion out here. Championship points for Wang Chuqin. Second bounce on the table. Ooh, the soft hands. What a way to save championship points.
Wow. I mean, we've seen remarkable composure and acknowledging that they can slow things down even when they're trailing. And now, Ban Jindong literally with his back against the wall.
Just off the table, long. Three championship points left for Wang Chuqin. Another one on the serve. Calmly walks over the towel box. Third towel break. With the underdog, Wang Chuqin, on his championship points. And he back in, Wang Chuqin takes down Ban Jindong, the world number one, has been defeated. What a performance. The fans absolutely in tears. Hugs all around.